shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer. Come on, shake your body, baby,
let's
do that
go!
Conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer.
I feel like I'm dancing today, boys!
Why?
And J-Fig.
Yes.
I feel like I'm dancing on the top!
Ooh.
On top of a conference! Number one! Not number two! Not avoiding anybody! Not number three, like some cheap bum charlatan! Not jockeying for position! You don't jockey for anything when you're secretariat! And when you dangerously loom, you loom from the top. That, my friends, is heat culture.
By the way,
tell him, Lefko.
There's a difference There's a difference between dangerously looming and peering. The Heat are peering down on the rest of the conference.
Hello, everybody else.
They are dangerously looming while looking up.
Hey, how you doing down there, Milwaukee? Oh, I see you all the way down there, Brooklyn. Oh, hello, Philly. Bums. Doesn't matter what was thrown the Heat's way this year. Let's just look back at this, everybody, okay? Bam Adebayo, first major injury. Didn't matter. Jimmy Butler broke his ass, broke his ankles, came back, didn't matter. Kyle Lowry was out for God knows what reasons, but we're happy he's back, didn't matter. Tyler Hero missing time, Victor Oladipo on the mend, working in all these guys undrafted that you never heard of before, Caleb Martin on a two-way contract. All that being said, people giving all this attention to Milwaukee, all the attention given to Brooklyn, everybody fawning over Philly. And where are they? Staring up at the standings at your number one seed, mother bleeping Miami Heat.
Hey, that was close.
To what?
Flynn Monster.
No, I was on a roll, dude. Rattling.
You were crackling.
But I didn't.
Goosey's galore.
So, tell him, Mike.
So, is it safe to say that both Philly and Boston lost?
Yeah. What, do you think I'm doing this for no reason?
It wouldn't be the first time.
You think I'm just doing this for you? No, it's official. Officially official. There goes Leroy in that first segment, closing out his tab once again.
Oh, what? How did this
happen? I don't know. I don't understand what he's doing. I don't know if he's like trading stocks or something on the Russian market, but he keeps doing that with his StreamYard where he keeps exiting. I don't know what that is. But isn't he adorable? Like, I just want to pinch his cheeks where he's like, wait, is it safe to say that Philly lost Boston lost? Yes, it's fair to say that.
I'm just messing with you because for reasons I cannot explain, when things like this happen, my Twitter blows up. And here's what happens. They don't send me Leroy. And so, here, I can't wait for tomorrow. No games in hand.
Woo! No need. Hey, Atlanta. Wait. I don't know why you're showing up tonight. Hey, why don't we just call this one, huh? What do we need to play for?
Hey, there's more. That's a win, that's a loss. Played out perfectly.
Mwah. Love it. What a time to be alive. What a time to be alive. What a season.
One person feels bad for me.
Hmm?
Leroy keeps catching strays on this app. I do.
Yeah, sorry.
I'm just an innocent bystander on Twitter.
Innocent is a loose term.
Getting hit with debris.
Innocent is a loose term. Are you innocent? Here's the thing. I told you this team was going to be the best in the East. All right? I told you back at that's a win, that's a loss, where this team was going to be and where this thing was going. Okay? I always wanted Kyle Lowry. Okay? I said, perfect floor general to add to this squad. I love Low Dog. And what has he done? Done nothing but be a floor general. Unbelievable job by him. I always told you. I told you back in the offseason, Leroy, when I was boots on the gram. And what did I tell you about Tyler Hero? Baby goat? He's a grown-ass bucket now. Muscles. Jacked. Strong. He's strong like Bull going to that rim now. I told you. All right? This team melting together. PJ Tucker. The perfect culture marriage. It's like a long-lost love. A long-lost pen pal. Finally reunited. Where they should always been. Eric Spoelstra. Top 15er of all time. Finally getting the respect he deserves. But all the while, this country is sitting here talking about the Lakers and the Nets and power rankings. You had to force feed them like a baby with broccoli. Had to force feed them culture down their throat because all they wanted to do was talk about Joel Embiid. And what's going to happen to Ben Simmons? He's dead to you. He doesn't even play basketball. You spent the entire season talking about a guy who doesn't get off his ass and obsessing about a fat bum who will never win an NBA championship.
Fat bum.
All the while ignoring a team that if it wasn't for a bum foot of an adorable Slovenian, would already be hoisting a Larry O'Brien trophy going for their second in 3 years. That's why there's always going to be an asterisk. And we've truly seen, who's the real Bubble Boys? Huh? Who? Who is the real Bubble Boys? Because Riley told you, there's always going to be that asterisk. And now you know. And now you know. All those guppies. Well, what now? Because last I checked, I haven't seen any suds around. Have you? Because the only thing looking squeaky clean right now is the Heat's record. You bums, you doubters, you haters, you charlatans.
Bum.
All of you who took a 4-game losing streak. Oh, this might be the end for Jimmy Butler and Derek Spoelstra. Shut up, Windhorst. You wish. You wish you had an out clause for your beloved LeBron James.
Maybe you could trade Russell Westbrook for Jimmy Butler. Blah, 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 blah.
Nope. Sorry. What about all you idiots who told me Frank Vogel was the best coach LeBron ever had?
Boom.
It's all happening for us, baby. So excited. It'd be like going to a one-seed store and say, hey, you got any Celtics? Nope. Sorry. We don't sell that here.
Wait. May I ask?
Yeah.
Just out of curiosity.
Yeah.
What is a one seed store?
Yeah, it's like, you know, when you go to the garden section at Home Depot. Hey, you got any seeds? Oh, I got these. I need some Celtics one seed. Oh, sorry. Don't have it. You can have some three seed if you want.
What does three seed grow?
Oh, just lower than the one seed, dude. Lower than the one seed. They have to put it much. Have to put it much deeper in the dirt.
Plants.
Oh yeah, like little weeds. Bums.
Bum.
All right.
A lot of doubters and haters and oh, I'm so excited, Leroy. I'm so proud of this team and what they were able to do. All the adversity that they faced, physical adversity and a smidge of emotional adversity, and here they sit. They were said not true content. This is what they said. I invented not a true. They told me not a true contender. They said there were dangerous loomers. What the hell does that even mean? I know one thing. If you loom from above, like the anvil over the coyote. Bums. And speaking of anvil, the hammer and the anvil.
Hold on. Let's first of all.
What?
The anvil does not loom above the coyote.
I think it does.
The anvil looms above the roadrunner.
No, because it always falls on the coyote.
Yes, it does.
Nope.
The coyote is the one Look, I'm not going to sit here and learn you about my childhood cartoons.
Okay, dude. Okay? Yeah, I didn't watch Looney Tunes. You know what I watched?
Clearly you didn't if you think the anvil was looming over the coyote.
It did. It fell on him all the time. He put the signs that helped me.
It fell on him, but it wasn't looming. He was trying to hang off the cliff and drop the anvil on top of the Roadrunner.
Well, guess what? You watch Looney Tunes. I watch Loomy Tunes.
The hell's that?
Dangerously looming. Looming Tunes? Not a fan of that one?
Hey, by the way, we just giving plus ones all willy-nilly today.
Yeah. It's a good day.
We all one seed. We all one seed. That's all, folks. One seed. Back after this.